As we recognize the 2019 Region 14 Division 3 Conference Champions, your CBC Cougars. I am Director of Athletics Paul Cantrell, and it'll be my pleasure to guide us through today's ceremony. And as we get started, just a couple of housekeeping items. This event is being recorded by our information technology department, so that recording will be posted on our Coastal Maine College YouTube site later this afternoon. As well as, don't be in a rush to like hurt yourself getting up from your seat to shoot a picture of your son as they get a championship ring. We have our director of public relations and marketing, our photographer here. They will be taking pictures. Those will be posted on the Coastal Maine College Facebook site, and you certainly can download those for free. So, as well, at the conclusion of today's event, we have both this backdrop and one out in the hallway, which are available for you guys to use and record your moment with your championship in any way that you would like. Later today, we'd like to ask the members of the team, if they're still around campus, to come by the gymnasium. We have a men's basketball game starting at 4:00, and at halftime, we will certainly honor the team again at that time. And finally, out of respect for the student athletes, as well as the speakers that are with us today, we would ask that you take a moment to silence your cell phones so that we don't have anything disturbing happening for us. So as we get going, obviously we have a lot of people that we'd like to thank for being here. Certainly, we'd like to thank B.B. Amadez, who is representing the Beeville Sports Hall of Fame. So there'll be more about that coming up in just a moment. From our Board of Trustees, Secretary Victor Gomez is in the house with us today. And from the Athletics Department, our Assistant Athletic Director, Vicente Garza, Director of Public Relations and Marketing, Bernie Sines, our Director of Information Technology, Amador Ramirez. And obviously, a whole lot of parents, without them, none of what you accomplished in May would be possible. So, at this just brief moment, ladies or gentlemen, if you should give your parents a standing ovation for their support. Okay, so let's go ahead and get this thing underway. I'm going to go ahead and bring up the secretary from the Board of Trustees, Victor Gomez, who is going to give a few words from the leadership of our institution and congratulate the gentleman.
I want to say, first of all, congratulations. Huge, huge event in your lives. And many more to come, I hope, after this. The only thing I want to say quickly is the rest of the board would have loved to have been here. Unfortunately, they're engaged in several different activities, and our administrative team is in Houston with the SAC-COC event. So, unfortunately, they couldn't be here, but I know that every one of them has spoken to me and asked me to reach out to every one of you and say congratulations. Job well done. And again, please a round of applause from us. Is in CBC history. Several years ago, when we decided to rebuild Joe Hunter Stadium and redo the field, it was myself and a few other community members and the board members decided, let's do this and let's set our eyes on the championship and let's go forward. Your mark in our history proved that when you put your mind and effort together and you have the right person in the leadership seat and you put the great team members together, you folks, anything's possible. So thank you for your mark on Coastal Bend College's history.
As Secretary Gomez mentioned, our president, our provost, our other vice presidents, and virtually every dean at our college are all in Houston this weekend for the SAC COC meetings, which is obviously important for us as an institution to retain our credibility. And so that's why they can't be here with you today, but all of them send their congratulations to you. So, as a small surprise, we're going to bring up a former Cougar, not just a former Cougar, but a former Cougar baseball player, back when the letters said BCCC. And he is going to have a little special surprise for the members of the 2019 team. BB?
Congratulations. Yes, as he did say, I was in class of 80 and 81. Played baseball in a whole different field that y'all have now. At the time, I want you to know that at the time when we were playing, or I was here back in the 70s and 80s, that was a state-of-the-art stadium compared to what it is now. So go full circle here. But again, I am here for one reason. I am part of the Beauville Sports Hall of Fame. And what that is we established this in 2004. Michael Silvers and myself put together a program that inducts sports athletes, not only in A.C. Jones High School for Beauville, but also what used to be Lac Canada before they integrated back in 1956 to the high school. Because that used to, Lac Canada used to be a high school, as some of y'all might remember. And of course, we also included CBC at the time, and of course, a Coastal Bend College now. And so, with that, we want to take the honor and the pleasure of this year inducting the champions into our Beaver Sports Hall of Fame today. That has actually been inducted as far as Coastal Bend College, a baseball team. We've inducted a coach, Coach Leach, who I, of course, played for back in that day, and of course, another coach, Steve Castile, who also played here and went on to coach Moody and went on to coach state championship at Moody as well. So we've had a lot of talent come out of here as well. So with that, we want to congratulate you. This is a pre-ceremony that we're going to use in October or whenever our Hall of Fame banquet is in the fall is when we'd like to present the plaque to the school on behalf of you guys as far as that goes. And of course, we want to congratulate Coach Barley. Outstanding job. Later on after, I can take a picture with all you guys behind this banner when we get done afterwards, so we can submit it to our Hall of Fame committee that put that together. And again, congratulations and thank you. Bye.
Obviously, none of this is possible without the captain of the ship. And at this time, we would like to have the skipper. Head Coach Brian Barley come up and say a few words.
Wow, what one hell of a ride. Pleasure to be here today.
guys, congratulations on your accomplishments. I'd like to thank Dean Ludwig and Sarah 4.5 years ago for hiring me, giving me the opportunity to be here today. Thank you. I told you what we were going to do, and we accomplished it. Far-fetched dream, but dreams do come true. Thank you all for being here. Without the family support, I appreciate everything y'all did over the last couple of years. Grandma's, grandpa's, driving, coming to the game, supporting the guys, supporting us as a team, good or bad. We did have a rough season last year at times, but we kept grinding, and at the end of the day, we were able to accomplish what our goal was. Fell a little short of the ultimate goal, but accomplished something when we only had 17 wins going into the last month of the season and ended up accomplishing what we accomplished was pretty special. Had to maybe get rid of a guy here or there along the way, but I always say cut out some cancer and good things will happen, and congratulations, guys. Mr. Cantrell said earlier that it would be possible without your family members, your moms, your dads, your grandparents, the great supporting cast that you had throughout your time here at Coastal Bend College. Appreciate everything, the donations. Probably tell them yourself at some point in time during the season, what the hell is Coach Barley doing right here? We got guys on first and second. Double stealing with no outs. The things we do are a little different than other people. We try to put pressure on other teams to keep them off guard. And if we execute, play the way we play baseball at Coastal Bend College, anything's possible. I'd like to thank you guys for the foundation you laid for the future guys to come. Y'all being able to have this opportunity to accept these rings today will be something you'll never forget in life. I can still remember my junior college days, and I have more friends from my junior college days than I do from my four-year school, because junior college baseball is a totally different thing than anything else. You're going to go through the good, the bad, the indifferent, the learning experience as a young man. Hopefully we understand from our mistakes. That's all we can ask for as coaches. I mean, I know we're all going to make mistakes. Hope that the guys do respond in a better way after the mistake. Don't make the same mistake twice, whether it be good, bad, indifferent. Hopefully this is something for our future team this year. Hopefully they can accomplish the same goal. We have all those teams here today for a reason, to show them, hey, this is what it's all about right here. This is what you're working for the future. And anything is possible. 17 wins with 1 month left, man. Who would have thought it? We kept believing. I also doubted us at some time soon. But this group, with a special group, never quit fighting, never gave in. And again, congratulations to you guys. I got one thing to say real quick. When I recruited Bo Gonzalez, game 7, Bo didn't pitch for us his freshman year, maybe one or two innings, if that. We didn't have much depth that first year. I mean, we were ranked number 2 in the country. We had about 12 guys that really played a big part as far as position player-wise. We were in a position to where we didn't have enough depth. We had to play in the third and first when Ruben pitched, and we did some different things. And me and Benito wanted to throw him more, but we weren't able to, just because of the situation we were in offensively on the year that year. So last year we made it a point to get more guys, to have more depth, and give him an opportunity to throw more. And I remember when I recruited him, his dad asked me, "Well, can Bo help you win a championship?" And I said, "Hell yeah." Who was on the mound in game 7 against Tyler? Bo Gonzalez. Congratulations for your performance that day, Bo, and everybody else that came through. But that's something I'd just like to say. And through all the things we went through, congratulations again, guys. And I'd like to bring up Tyler Bo today to give a little 5-10 minute talk. So. By the way, he's your all-time hit leader in Coastal Bend College history.
I just want to kind of start by saying, thank you, Coach Barley and coaching staff, for giving me the opportunity to come to Coastal Bend when I really didn't know if I was going to have an opportunity to play anymore after leaving Alvin after my freshman year. And midsummer didn't even have a place to play. And Coach Borley called me and said he'd give me an opportunity. And, you know, it turned out to work out really good for me. So I just want to say thanks, Coach Borley and the coaching staff. And also, I'm just going to kind of talk about last year's team, you know, how it went, how the season went. And I just want to say, you know, this group of guys is amazing. You know, resiliency, like you said, the opportunities, you know, that we had to give in and give up, and we never did. And it was quite a ride. So those guys right there, man, really resilient group of guys. I just want to, last year, you know, kind of started out pretty rough. You know, like I said, 3-9, that was a really rough season. And we kind of turned it around. We had every opportunity to lay down and give up, and we never did. And, you know, that group of guys said a lot about the character of the group of guys that we have. Coming to CDC turned out to be one of the best decisions I've ever made. You know, it was a perfect spot for me to develop, not only as a person and a student, but as an athlete. So I just want to say thank you to everyone that had a hand in that. You know, Vinny, you know, everybody, Paul. I just want to close by saying thank you to everyone who made that possible, and thank you to my teammates, who are the most resilient group of guys I've ever got to play with.
Some hardware. So we're going to go ahead and take care of these three guys first, as obviously this is sort of the brain trust of our baseball program. So first up, Dalton Rodriguez. Coach Ryan Benitez.
Yeah.
Lester.
Just be politicians, be preachers. 24th, Michael Dinsdale. Number 25, Josh Mendez. Number 26, Devin Iguado.
we're going to ask the team members to come back up to the stage for a series of photographs that will be taken by Mr. Braden. After that, you are free to take as many photographs as you want, as a group, individuals, whatever you want, you've got. So, coaches, thank you. We're getting ready to wrap this thing up. Oh, we'll do that. Yeah, we'll include the banner in those photographs. So, the reality is of this, you are the 2019 Region 14 Division 3 champions. Something that no one, except Coach Barley, thought was possible 3.5 years ago. And he proved that it is absolutely possible. Now, for those members of the team for 2020, the opportunity to be on this stage next fall is yours. The opportunity to put a banner up that is maybe one rung higher than Region 14 champions is yours. Could that championship be a district championship? Could that championship be a national championship? Gentlemen, the opportunity is yours. It has been my honor to stand here before you and present these champions. For those of you who might be interested in potentially having a piece of your own Region 14 championship hardware, there is that opportunity. These rings were paid for by money raised by our baseball team. If you would like to participate in that fundraising exercise, there are brochures located outside saying Championing Champions, which is exactly what we've done here today, as we have celebrated the 2019 Region 14 Division 3 Champions, the Coastal Bend College Cougars. With that, gentlemen, good luck with your finals. Don't get to say that often to almost half that group that's no longer with us. To our current guys, good luck with finals. To everyone else, very happy holidays. Go Cougars. Thank you. Gentlemen, you come back up to the stage.
Yeah.